Hello and welcome to a new quick tutorial. This is a section of a 4-hour long step-by-step tutorial that you can find in the description. The tutorial is also intended for beginners. The whole scene was created in the free program Blender. To make the tutorial easier to follow, I made a floor plan of the pool rooms by looking at some reference pictures from the internet. Now we can easily create walls by extruding one vertex and following the reference image. By pressing E, Z6, I extruded the edges along the Z-axis by 6 meters. To create the zigzag lines, I added about 10 loop cuts on both sides. Selected every other row, switched from global to normal orientation and moved the walls along the X-axis. To get rounded walls, we need bevels of different values. If we use the default angle method, we can use the same bevel value everywhere. But if we switch to the weight method, then we can define the bevel value of each edge separately. This way we keep the entire pool rooms non-destructive and we can change shapes later as desired. To create a circular staircase, I use Array Modifier and Empty Object. Empty Object is used to control the rotation and the distance between the steps. To create the windows and keep them non-destructive, I use a Boolean modifier. Since we need a lot of windows, I created a collection and switched the Boolean modifier from object to collection. Now everything inside the collection works as Boolean. For lighting, I added a slightly orange color and increased the power to 10. I also added the sun. By increasing the sun angle, you can get softer shadows. I created the window sibling by adding loop cuts with Ctrl R, inserting with I or I twice to insert face on the individual origins. To create the handrail, I start with the plane, took only top edges, bevel and turned them into curve. Now I have the options to add depth to the curve. For glass material, I mix glass and transparent shader. For roughness, I use concrete texture. For bump, mask grip texture. I used the panels we built in the last tutorial for the backroom lighting. All tutorials and project files are in the description. For the tile material, I first started with the texture from ambientcg.com, but since the texture doesn't have much information, I decide to combine with the Chocofur concrete shader that you can download for free. For the water, I first added the ocean modifier to add some real geometry. For the water material, I mixed glass and transparent shader and used the video footage of the water for a bump and displacement. To break up the repetitive texture, I use the mask grip texture. Blender Scenes version 3.2 has a new shadow caustics, but this won't work for us because we need the sun hitting the water and we have a ceiling in our scene. I decided to create a slight caustics effect on the ceiling, although it may not be physically accurate in this example. For that I used the fake method with the spotlight and video texture that I found for free. Finally, I added a few imperfections. A bit of real geometry always comes in handy in places where the camera passes, as well as graffiti and leaky texture. A bit of garbage here and there give the impression that someone in the past also got stuck in the pool room's maze. I decide to render the animation in 640 by 480 pixels to get the original VHS resolution, although on the other hand I lost a lot of details. I want to achieve the VHS type look from the early 90s. You can find the entire pool rooms, back rooms and 8 other tutorials on the link below.